Hi guys, welcome back to another video, and here we are in part 2 of Warwick Rovers. It was a bad start to the season. We lost 5-1 or something, wasn't it? But new signings in last season was Adam, 17 years old. He came from Elche, and he's Spanish. Our striker then 60 rated, but he has enough to grow. We've got Garrido, and he's 19 years old, Spanish again. 5'7" and comes from Barcelona on loan to us. So it was actually a good deal, I think. I was trying to get him on a full deal, but they wouldn't let us do that. So you might have to try and finalise his deals coming to the end of the season. So this video will go until the middle bit of the season, so January, and we'll stop it in January, and then we'll finish off the season in the next episode. So yeah, let's get into it. Well, this is a future me, because this video is kind of filmed in like November sometime. Yeah, but it's coming out quite late. But yeah, in this clip I did say like, oh, let's try to get to 70 subscribers and stuff. But no, we've actually hit 100 subscribers. I'm so happy. I just woke up this morning and we had 107. Well, now we're down to 106, but it's fine. We're up to 100. That was our goal for the end of last year, and I'm really happy. And coming into the first few games here, we won against Morecambe, but it's not been very successful. We've lost, and we lost again against Barrow. So Morecambe in the league 2-1, we beat them. Carabao Cup against Carsley United, and EFL Cup against Accrington Stanley. Gillingham up next in the league. So yeah, just present me though, saying thank you for 100 subscribers. Huge goal for me, and I'm really excited for the future of this channel. So it really helps if you just smash that subscribe button and like, and yeah, I'll stick with you until the next bit. But yeah, this episode is the huge one, the one where we sign 2 massive people for League 2. So back to the action.
Here we go, and Archie Gray is our star signing. 19 years old, an Englishman from Leeds United in the Championship, down to League 2, only 1.4 million. It was a great signing, and I knew he was on my radar the whole time. But yeah, here he is then, Archie Gray. He's got 5,100 and a 3 million release clause. Thomas Elek comes in, he's a free agent, and I don't know what rating he is, but let's see if we are, well, we're always going to get an A because it's free, but he's only 50 rated. That was a bit of a rubbish one, but yeah. But he's only 16, so he has time to grow. But our final signing is coming up soon. So we have sadly lost Neil, our centre back. He was 31 years old, but a new one should be coming in soon. It is transfer deadline day. See, Neil goes for 310k to Alcorn, but we've got 7 hours left. Let's see who we can get. Also, Mark Brown is heading out. He is 32 years old. We're not going to use him. So 100k, and he's off to Colchester, who we lost to in our first match. And we're not going to accept Clarks. So yeah, let's see who we can get. We promote Sun Heat Park, 16 years old, and he is 57 rated at the moment, but he could grow and be a young star. Here we go then, Sam McCallum. He's our number one centre back, 22 years old. I'm not sure what rating he's going to be, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be our number one. He's not a centre back, he's either going to play in the, well, he's going to play on the left back role. Here he is then, Sam McCallum from Norwich. 1.5 million, not a bad deal actually. He was actually quite a low amount of money, but he's 70 rated. Wow, and he's gonna, yeah, he's definitely our number one in the whole squad, actually. Because even though you have, what's his name? Hughes, who's 70 rated, and Bradley, who's nearly 70 rated. Those two are 28 and 28, so, yeah. But, here we go, then, Sam McCallum. He goes on that wing, and look at him. He's made that back line look much more secure, and I'm happy with that now. But Alan is not going to be on the bench. It's going to be our newly promoted Park. So he's a centre back. So if he grows enough, I'm going to actually convert him to a right back. Then when he grows enough, he can go in for McFadden. Park's going to grow more, so he's probably going to overtake McFadden already. So, let's go to Squad Hub, and let's scroll down to find Sunhee Park. I think he's going to be the next team in somebody's defender instead. But yeah, let's go into here, and what's it say? 17 weeks for him to get to the next. So, I think we're going to... Yeah, I think we're going to keep him on a balance for now. Then let's just put him on a left back thing as well. So that's going to take him 100 weeks. It's going to be difficult, but I think he can do it. It will be done by the end of the season, I know that. But I mean, like, it's going to be difficult for 100 weeks. But then again... Can we hire any coaches? Let's see. Defence, that's where he plays. We can. So we're going to get... I'm going to fill out these in. There we go then. So we got 7. Our ideal is 10 for attack. But when we get more options for more amount of staff, because we're only allowed 6, we'll get more. But yeah, or we'll get better ones and we'll just fire the other ones. But we've got Lawson in the midfield. Only him. Got 2 in the defence, which makes it 7 out of 12. And 4 out of 7 in the back with Morsley. Come on then, Warwick. You can do this. And quick sim against Tranmere. Can we get some more points on the board? And yes, we can! Archie Gray! I knew he'd be our star signing. He gets a late goal. 15 minutes. Well, 14 minutes before the end to make it 1-0 in the end. Now, let's see then. After the end of 2 months and, well, in the 2nd of December now, let's see where we are in the standings. We are 13th, just behind newly promoted Notts County. And last is Mansfield Town. But Wrexham are on top at the moment, but it's really close, actually. We're on 8. Separating 7th and us is, let me work this out, yeah, literally 3 points. So a win and then all a loss for the rest ahead of us. We could be up to legit 7th here. So we could be looking for promotion this season. Let's look at our objectives. It says, get a streak of 7 games without defeat. There, EFL League 2, finish mid-table. So that's actually good. Because current position, we are 13th, so that's not mid-table. Well, it is actually. One more position, that would be mid-table, but yeah. For myself, I think we can go and gun for that promotion now. So, let's sim to the middle of the season. And what the hell has happened here? That only means for at least a month, in a month, we've only scored 4 points. That puts us 22nd. And we're gunning for promotion this season. Well, Barrow are up there with Wrexham.
fighting for that first. But how have we dropped down to 20 seconds? I want promotion here, so we need a better month. Next up, we've got Doncaster, and then Stock. And what a climb from 20 seconds to 14th coming into December. And, well, to get up to the top seven for at least the playoffs, coming 20 games in now, and we're playing Wrexham up next. We did lose 4-0 to Stockport at one point. But yeah, we've been more successful actually, and we've started to work together more. But yeah, only 4 points separate us in seventh place. So we could actually go for promotion here. I don't think it'll be automatic. We're going to have to go through the long way. But yeah. But if we go to squad, let's see if there's been any big anybody's really gone up. Bradley, so three in this back line now are 70 rated. Arch Gray has gone up by one. Garrido's gone up by one. Adam's gone up by one. Hams has gone up by one. Woodward's. Oh, wait, no, Hams has stayed the same, sorry. Woodward's gone up by one. McFadden stayed the same. And Barrett is gone up one. And he's now, will be now nearly our third 70 rated player. Where's Park? Park has gone up one rating. Not bad. Fuller's gone up one as well. This is looking good. And I think now we've just got to hope that they keep up this form. Coming for the last month now until we end the episode here for January. And on a quick note, we've just beaten Wrexham 2-1, who were actually leading, and then we've just beaten Swindon. What a push. The boys are going for it. The Rovers are going for it, and it's a 3-0 win against Newport County. Oh my god, what is happening? Three wins in a row, that's the first time I think that's happened. Let's see what happens against Notts County, and then I'll keep it a secret until we get to the 1st of December and Notts County beat us 1-0. That's a bit depressing. Well, a good note is we made it out top of the group in the Northern Section Group D, and now we're into round two against Crawley Town. But let's go. Carabao Cup, where were we knocked out? We were knocked out round two against Carsley. That's where we got knocked out by Carsley. Where are we in this? Nowhere? Where are we in the FA Cup? Oh, we're against Crystal Palace in round three. Next then. And we beat we were 0-0 against Swindon, but then we beat them 1-0. And we also beat Morecambe 2-1 in the first bit. Ah. Oh. Right, let's go to pick competition. And let's go to League 2. Let's see. Oh, we stayed 14th. Ah, and it's still 4 points that just separates us and 7th. It's going to be a huge push now. We need to just keep winning now. But we're going to... we're going to go to February and we're going to end it there then. So let's go push for the final month then. Come on, you Rover. And I have just had bad news. Woodward, after this season, will be leaving us. Well, yes, he was old. So, yes, we can get a new person. But, I mean, like, yeah, that's a bit annoying. But, yeah, because he has 6 months left on his contract. Cameron Fuller will be leaving to Blackburn Rovers. Has a lot of this happened then? Has a lot of people... Yes. Wood is going. Elijah Wood. Who's he? I don't know. But yeah. I think we're keeping most of the people in our starting 11 though. So I think we're fine. But yeah. First of... Here's Wood, let me just say. Oh, he's our backup goal.
cheaper. But that's not bad because he's 24 and he's 25, so actually, I don't really mind about that. Because I think we're going to get a new goalkeeper. But yeah, 1st of February and we are sitting 11th. So we have made a climb, just a little climb. And we are actually drawn on points for 7th. So if you didn't put in all the goal differences and stuff into play, we would be drawn with 7th. Yeah, but because all the things happen, we are 11th. But yeah, at the bottom are Morecambe, Harrogate, Colchester, and at the top is Wrexham, Tranmere Rovers, and Bradford City. How are Tranmere Rovers up there? How are Walsall up there? Bloody hell. They've been stuck in that League 2 for ages, and Walsall are actually in this playthrough. In these episodes, are actually climbing up. They are fourth at the moment. I'll be impressed if, I know it's not our team, but I mean, I'll be impressed if they got promoted. But yeah, this will end it then for, this episode, sorry. Episode 3 will be coming soon. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on your notification bell so you don't miss the next upcoming videos. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you all next time in episode 3. Goodbye!